Well, good morning and welcome to a very cold and autumnal Esnes Quarry in Warhampton. This is a lovely day to keep water. It's run by Freshwater Fisheries and it's got some cracking carp up to over 40 pounds. And I'm down here for a night, not just to try and catch a fish out this lake, but also to give you a bit of a catch up about what's been going on in my fishing over the last 5 or 6 months. I think it was about 5 or 6 months ago in the spring this year when we sat down and had a catch up about what I've been doing during the winter months. Well, since then there's been quite a lot going on. So I'm gonna push this barra round to my swim, which is just round the corner, get myself set up, and then we'll have a quick chat about the lake, conditions on the water and what's in here, etc. And then we'll start talking about how my fishing's been going over the last few months. So let's get round there, because it looks really, really nice at the moment. This looks a good area to try. This is peg 6, it's right in the middle of the lake. Lots of variety of depth, and also I've got that nice autumnal sun shining on my face, which is gonna be nice and warm today. The lake's really quiet, there's only a couple of guys down, and they're down to my left, both opposite one another, the deepest end of the lake, which I think always tends to do really well at this time of the year on this lake. But it's a far contrast from when I was last down here. I think it was early March when I last fished this lake, and it was proper cold. It was teeming down with snow, and I ended up with about 6 or 7 inches of snow, but I managed to catch one, which was a fish that we covered in the last catch-up vlog that we did. So after that though, where I ended up going was onto my Lincolnshire Syndicate. That was the last week of my winter syndicate. I ended up with a really good couple of fish, because prior to then, I'd caught 2 40-pounders during the winter on that lake, which is a really great winter. But the last week, I ended up with another couple of 40-pounders. So what a great way to finish my winter time on that lake. So what we're going to do now is just quickly take a look at some of that footage. And whilst we do that, I'm going to quickly get myself set up, because the dog's desperate to sit down and I would want to get the rods out as quickly as I possibly can. So I'll leave you with those for now, and I'll join you again in a minute. Absolutely crazy. 41 pound mirror. Just mega. Quite a tired face this morning, but a happy man anyway, because I've had a 41 pound mirror in the night, and a bit of a comedy of errors with it as well, because the older I get, the more I seem to do daft things. I mentioned this last month when I did one of my vlogs, and I don't know how I did it, but I got out of the bed when I had this bite. I put my shoes on, but I put them on the wrong feet, so I had my left shoe on my right foot. So I was hobbling all over the place. I don't know how I got out the door, but I've managed to break the zip on the bivvy door because I fell through it. I don't know what happened, I can't remember. And then I'll just show you, staggering down to the rods, down all of there, I ended up tripping over. I don't know where I tripped over, but I ended up on my knees whilst the rod was blating off. So a bit of a comedy of errors, but I managed to get the fish in. And yeah, a 40 pounder is always going to be welcome on a March morning, and it is definitely a nice morning. The wind swung around a little bit now. It's blowing more westerly, probably more in favor of the swims on that bank, big double, and where I fished before, but I've only got one night left, so I'm going to stick it out in here. Can't really say come on carp gods, because I've had a fantastic winter as it is already, but I would definitely love another one before we finish tomorrow. So, but either way, I'm definitely not complaining. Well, what a brilliant way to end my winter syndicate. Last session, 2 40-pounders. Absolutely brilliant. Can't wait to get back. That was definitely a winter to remember, to catch 4 winter UK 40s. I've never done it before. I'm probably unlikely to do it again either. And you know, off the back of that though, I ended up getting myself a full ticket on that particular syndicate lake. And we'll go back to that lake later on in the year, because I've done quite a bit of fishing on there during the back end of summer. So straight after finishing my winter syndicate on there, which ended the end of March, I then had a few commitments to do for Avid. First one was a 24-hour session down at Hawcott Lakes with a guy called Trev Cornwall, which he'd won a competition to fish for 24 hours with myself, and down there on a great lake, great day ticket lake. And in the dying minutes of packing up, it was one of those really tough sessions. He managed to catch his second ever biggest carp, which was absolutely great because I love it when things go to plan. And straight after that, I was then over at the Forces Carp Classic, which is a great event which raises a lot of money for charity for ex-servicemen, and the army were there, the ambulance service, or the blue light services as they call them, the RAF, the Navy. It was a great event. I did a talk about carp fishing, specifically catching big fish, and it was great seeing those guys over there. It was a fantastic event. But after that, the next bit of carp fishing that I did was probably one of my most enjoyable ones this year, which was at East Delft Lakes, a really well-known day ticket venue down in the sort of Cambridgeshire area. Now, I've known about this lake for, well, this complex of lakes for quite a few years. It's been on the circuit for a number of years on the day ticket circuit, and you get to exclusively get either the back lake or the front lake or one of the other two lakes that's on site. And we had the back lake, Avid did, to do a film over there for 48 hours. And I was on there with Adam Johnson, one of the cameramen from Avid, and we had the lake to ourselves. And it just was absolutely brilliant. It was just a fantastic 48 hours of fishing. From the moment we put the rods out, we started catching fish right the way through to the end. And the conditions was perfect as well, because it was that time of the year when spring, you get a bit of rain, a bit of hail, a bit of sunshine. The carp was jumping, they was on the feed, and it was really exciting, hard fighting fish, all really nice looking carp as well. So if you're interested in booking out one of the East Delft Lakes, it definitely gets a thumbs up from me, because we caught some really nice carps, about mid upper 20 I think from memory, including some nice fully scales and heavily scaled mirrors, one or two commons as well, but a really enjoyable session, which you can see the full video on the Avid channel elsewhere on this page. And after that, we then went to a lovely water in deepest, darkest Lincolnshire. I've done quite a bit of fishing in Lincolnshire this year, and it's a lake that's owned by my good friend Dave Gardner. He took control of it a few years ago, and he's slowly done a bit of work on it and restocked it. It's called Brickyards Fishery, and it probably turns out to be one of the best looking carp lakes that I've fished this year. It's set right into the deepest countryside of Lincolnshire, and right amongst a load of countryside fields and farm buildings and farmland, really quiet, nice picturesque venue with some lovely carp in it as well. And I was there for 48 hours, and we did a full film on that, which again you can see elsewhere on the Avid channel. But we caught some nice fish. It was tricky fishing across to some snags at long distance, so it wasn't just about catching fish that film. It was about the tactical side of fishing for carp tight in snags, which, you know, it needs a specific approach, especially if you're fishing for hard fighting fish, which we were, you know, mostly 20 pounders, young fish that have got all that energy. And in those kind of conditions, it was pretty tough fishing, but enjoyable as well. And what we're going to do now is show you a little bit of that footage, and I'll let you make your own minds up about whether that is a really nice venue, because to me, it was absolutely stunning over there. Bearing in mind there's only 10 commons in this lake, we've not done too bad, because this is the fourth one we've caught during this short session, and it's my biggest one as well of the trip at 26.5 pounds. A brilliant way to end, and a massive thanks to Dave for a wonderful few days fishing on a very special carp water in North Lincolnshire. So with my commitments to Avid out of the way, it was time to do some syndicate fishing, because it's early spring, start of May, great time to be on the bank and chasing those big fish. And I'm fortunate that I've got a lot of different tickets up and down the country. I live in Yorkshire, and I've got quite a few northern tickets, but I've also got a few tickets down south as well. And my main focus was going to be a carp right down in Ringwood, a fish known as Saddleback, which is in the famous Roach Pit. Now, this particular carp had been caught in early April at about 58, 59 pounds, so there was a really good chance it was going to go to 60 pounds. So although it's a long drive from up in Yorkshire where I live to right down there, there's definitely something to drive for. And my first trip I went down there, I set my stall on fishing an area where Saddleback tends to get caught from the most. It's not a really good area for catching numbers of fish, but it's a good area for catching big fish. And the first three nights, it didn't surprise me that I ended up with a blank. I was back again the next week for another three nighter in the same area, but again it turned out to be a blank. And the week after I was back again, so a lot of mileage when it comes to target fishing, especially when you live in Yorkshire. And I was hoping to do three nights when I went down again, but unfortunately after the first 24 hours the lake was closed because the carp started to spawn. So a long old journey for me from Yorkshire down to Ringwood for a night, and a blank night at that. But you know, fair play to Alan for shutting the lake when the carp do spawn. I do agree with things like that. And you know, obviously I've got lots of other tickets around the country that I could turn to if I needed to, but that lake was closed for two or three weeks. And unfortunately, as happens quite a lot in different venues, there are some casualties from spawning. And sad to hear was that Saddleback, the fish that set my sights on catching, that was one of the casualties of this year's spawning. So with that in mind, I had lots of things going on in my head. Where do I go next? And where better to go than to over in Germany, where I've been a member of a really famous carp water for quite a few years now, a place called Mary and Joe Pool, the former German record venue, or the former world record carp venue as well. It was a carp known as Mary that used to live in there that topped the world record for a common many years ago. I think it topped out about 94, 95 pounds. But I love going fishing over there. I've got lots of good friends in Germany, and I've been a member on that lake now for quite a while. So I was really excited to go over there because it's a great time of the year to be on the bank in Germany. In England, you tend to find the big ones get caught about early May, middle of May, but in Germany, June is a great time to be on the bank over there. So I set myself 2 weeks. Got the car loaded up, got the dog down the vet, so she got a passport and I could take her into Germany and set off on a long old journey over there. But what a great time of the year to be on the bank. But I'd not put my plans into motion in the right way to start with, because I'd not realised that it was a bank holiday when the day that I arrived in Germany. So the lake was really busy and it was one of these long bank holidays, so I couldn't get into the area of where I wanted to fish for about 4 days. But I had 10 days still in front of me, and as soon as I got into the swim where I really had my sights set, I started catching carp, and it turned out to be a really great trip, because whenever I go to Germany, all I want to do is catch some fish. And it's a really tricky lake, that one is. It's not an easy venue to catch carp from, but you've always got in the back of your mind, I'd love to catch one of the big fish that's in there. And there are a couple of really big carp in there. The biggest mirror in there is called Mr. P, which tops out about mid 80s. And the biggest common in there is a carp known as Black Spot, which tops out at low 80s. And either of those two would have been absolutely great for me. And, you know, sometimes the stars align. I started catching some nice fish. And at the end of the trip, I think I'd had about 8 or 9 in total, topped by none other than Black Spot at a massive 76 pounds, which was my season's carp. You know, I couldn't have dreamt of catching a better carp than that, because to target a carp in Ringwood when you live in Yorkshire is very difficult, but to target a carp in Germany when you live in England, believe me, it really isn't easy. Staying in tune with the lake, keeping in touch with what's going on, knowing where the carp are at certain times of the year, piecing the jigsaw together, it's very, very difficult, but it paid off for me. And obviously there's still other carp in there that I want to catch, but to start with, catching Black Spot put a proper smile on my face. So what we're going to do now is take a look at some of that footage of that really magnificent fish over in Germany, which really was a season's carp for me.
Right. Whenever I come to Germany, I just want to catch one carp to make the trip worthwhile, but to catch the biggest common in the lake is just the stuff of dreams. So very, very happy. Definitely the icing on the cake from this trip.
I don't think it needs me to tell you that I do quite a lot of fishing. So bearing in mind I'm married, every now and again I need to make sure that my missus is okay. And throughout the year we do lots of long weekends away, especially up into the Lake District. It's our favourite place. So when I got back from Germany, we had our family holiday and we went up there for just over a week. Had an absolutely wonderful time, like we always do. Doing a lot of climbing and walking and just enjoying what is a beautiful part of England. But when I got back from there, there was still a bit of time to kill between then and when my Lincolnshire syndicate started on the summer ticket. It normally has a good old break when the carp have spawned. Sometimes it's shot for 6 to 8 weeks, you know, and this year it was about 8 weeks. So it's a good old length of time. It lets the fish recover. So I couldn't get on there, even though I was really itching to get back there. But I had a lot of time to kill between then and when it started. And I got a lot of nice invites to go and fish on various different waters and lots of places I'd never been to before. And one of those waters was a venue called 5 Acre Lake up in East Yorkshire. guy called Gordon Razor who runs it gave me an invite over there, and I went there for 24 hours and had a lovely session over there. A lake that's doing quite a lot of nice fish now for that area of England. It is an area that I used to live a few years ago as well, so I know it quite well. But I caught some lovely carp up to about 29 pounds, which was really enjoyable. Another water that I ended up going to was Girton. I do quite a lot of tutorials on the Cove Lake at Girton in between my sort of serious fishing and syndicate fishing and the work for Avid. And also I'm still a member of the main lake on there. You know, you might remember that last year I fished for butthead, the biggest carp in that complex, a carp which went 64 pounds when I caught it last year, an absolutely giant of a fish. But there's still lots of other good fish in Girton for me to go for, and I'm still a member on the syndicate there. And I went and did a bit of summer fishing, especially on the top, which I really enjoy, fishing off the surface. It's one of my favourite forms of carp fishing, and in the summer months Girton's a really obliging water for that kind of fishing. And I just enjoyed wandering around there with a surface rod, firing mixes out and catching one or two nice fish. So that brings us up really towards the, you know, the middle part of July, sort of end of July area. And it was looking nice for another trip out to Germany before I started fishing on the Lincolnshire Syndicate. And I put plans into motion, and this time I couldn't go for 2 weeks, which I'd done in June. I only went for 10 days, which is still long enough, and I had an absolutely fantastic time out there again. Hoping to get into Mr. P, the other big one that's in the lake that I really want to catch, but it did avoid me. But I was confronted with some really, really tough fishing as well, completely different lake to when I've been out there in the early part of June, because the weed had really flourished. It was top to bottom in 30 foot of water, which really was very, very tricky fishing, even to myself, who's pretty experienced at fishing in weed. But with the right gear, the right approach, and the right tactics, I did catch some really nice fish. So let's take a look at some of the fish that I caught from that session. Didn't catch any real monsters, because there's lots of 60 pounders in that lake and a few 70s and 80s, but it was nice catching a few 50s, which I'm sure you'll agree, some really nice fish. So let's move over there and take a look at that footage now.
We don't have caused you some problems. But I won't turn it down. It's in. Oof. With a ton of weed. Look at all that. That's a nice fish anyway. I thought it was a bit bigger than that because the bite was a proper big fish bite.
There's almost as much weed there as there is fish. But we got it in anyway, that's the main thing. Let's have a look at it on the mat.
Colossal fight and a 50 pounder. Must have made its way into every single weed bed in front of me. But I got him out and he's here now. Chucking it down with rain as well. Mega conditions, definitely a chance of another carp or two.
Obviously we're well into the summer now. Probably the hottest and warmest time of the year. Not necessarily the best time of the year to catch big carp, but obviously I was really looking forward to getting stuck into my Lincolnshire Syndicate, which was about to start from the moment I got back from Germany. But I had a couple of other little things to do in between, one of which was the Junior Carp Camp, which is run by the Carp Society. Absolutely great event. It's been running for many, many years, and it's really well supported by the trade. And Avid went down there, myself and Sam James went down there to help out for a couple of days. It's like, I think it's about 30 young kids who get paired with what are called tutors. They get taught bits and pieces about carp fishing on Horseshoe Lake, and hopefully at the end of it they catch a few fish as well. And there's lots of different segments on this camp where the guys can get taught about surface fishing, fishing with static rods, fishing for big carp, fishing for bites. So there's lots of people involved in it as well, lots of companies throughout the trade. Really great event, and hopefully we'll keep doing it all the time. But that was great to go there. But obviously, as soon as I'd finished there, I was now itching to get onto the Lincolnshire Syndicate. And basically the way it works is when it opens in the summer, this lake, you have the first week, which is saved for the owners of the lake and the bailiffs. And they had an absolutely crazy week. I don't know exactly how many carp they caught, but it was multiple fish getting caught, lots of big fish, lots of 40 pounders and 30 pounders, crazy statistics. And the actual first week of the syndicate, when the guys can go on there after the bailiffs week, it was going to be very busy. So I left that week alone, and I actually didn't go onto the lake until the second week of the syndicate being opened, which was towards the back end of July. But it had been well fished. The fish were starting to realise that they're under a bit of pressure, but they were still having a good old feed on the baits. And I think my first session on there, which was for 3 days, I ended up with 4 or 5 bites, and I lost a couple. And losing a couple of fish on this lake, you really don't want to lose them, because it's a lake that's got a lot of 40 pounders in it. Some really big fish, including half a dozen or so fish that could go, well, let's say there's three, four 50 pounders in there. So losing a carp on a lake like that, you just don't want it to happen. But I ended up with a couple of 30 pounders on my first trip. Really nice fish, some of them nice and scaly, old traditional English carp, proper carp as people like to call them. And they're all homegrown as well, and they're all nice lookers. And it's a really nice lake, this is. It's about 30 acres in size, and it's not necessarily I wouldn't call it an easy lake, I wouldn't call it a hard lake either. It's probably got about 400 carp in 30 acres, of which well over 200 of them, and that's why well over 200 of them were over 30 pounds. So it's a proper good big fish venue, and it's a nice lake to fish as well. There's a good syndicate on there, some really, really nice guys. I did all right in the summer months. I didn't do as well as I'd hoped to. Certainly didn't follow my winter on there, which was a really good winter, as well as I'd hoped to, because I think the biggest fish I caught during the summer months was only 38 pounds. Now that's still a big fish. I'm not saying only 38 pounds. Now this lake has got a lot of 40s in it, probably about 40 odd 40s at the right time of the year. So 38 pounder, it's not one of the better fish, let's put it that way. But it's obviously a very welcoming fish, really enjoyable fish to catch. And I had all sorts of weather thrown at me during the summer as well, as we all do. A lot of driving rain. We've had a really wet summer this year. So with a lot of rain on the lake, the fishing's been a little bit patchy. But consistently during the summer, I did okay. I caught some lovely 30 pounds. And one standout fish to me wasn't necessarily my biggest fish. It was a 35 pounder. And it was a really glorious heavily scaled mirror, because this lake's got a lot of nice scaly mirrors in it, and they're really nice dark in colour as well. Look like traditional old English carp, and which they are. And when I caught this 35, 36 pounder on this one morning, just before I was due to leave to go and see some of my friends from university, it was a real standout moment, because it was a really nice fish. Not necessarily one of the biggest, but just a really nice looking carp. So I had a good summer on there, and fished it sort of consistently, not necessarily every week, but every other week, probably from sort of the end of July till the end of August. And I sort of finished the summer months at the end of August on this lake. The autumn tends to start around about early September for me. And before I got into the autumn fishing on this lake, one of the things that I did was I also met up with a load of my old university mates, which is always a nice thing to do. If anybody out there has been to university, and it's about 30 odd years ago since I went to university, I spent a lovely week up in Leeds with a few of my mates from uni who I've not seen for a long while. And I ended up doing a master's degree in fisheries management when I was at university. So I did a degree and then a master's degree. And if I'm honest, I've not really used my master's degree in the fisheries capacity as like in fisheries consultancy work, which is what I'd hoped to do when I'd left university, because I ended up working more in the fishing trade. But has it been of any use to me? Well, it definitely has, because I do a lot of fishing in Germany, like I said, and to fish in Germany, you have to get a regular permit to fish on a lot of the lakes in Germany. You have to pass a proper fisheries test to get a license to fish in Germany, or you get one of these holiday licenses, and over the years I've always fished with the holiday license, but this year I've managed to get myself a full permanent license to fish in Germany, and I've not even had to sit the test. I've basically just had to show them that I've got a master's degree from university, and it's enabled me to bypass sitting down and doing the written exam to get into Germany. But having that new license in Germany has given me the opportunity to join a lot more waters for next year and in years to come, so I'm really happy about that. Another little thing I did before the autumn came around was a group of carp anglers meet up every year to play a bit of cricket. It's called the Felton Cup, this event that we do, which is down in the Surrey area, and it's organised by my old mate Chris Felton, long-time carp angler Chris. Caught a lot of big fish, including carp to over 90 pound overseas, and lots of really big fish in England. He's fished on the likes of Yateley Carp Park Lake. He's very sort of low-key, low publicity these days though, and he organises an event every year where he ends up putting a team of carp anglers together to fish against his brother's team. And his brother's a pretty famous guy, a lot more famous than anybody in carp fishing, because he used to be in the old Harry Potter series. He's Draco Malfoy. Chris Felton is his brother, and Tom Felton is the actor. And Tom, probably about 20 million followers on Instagram or something from the Harry Potter series. But Tom puts a team together, usually a combined of a lot of his old school friends and the carp anglers team. There's the likes of, well, there's me down there. There's sometimes Stevie Briggs turns up, and this year he did. And I ended up actually bowling Steve out in the, got to get this one in, Steve, in the nets before the game. And I got that one on phone as well, on my phone camera, which is a nice little memory. He'll hate me showing this one as well, but there's lots of other carp anglers in there. Jason Cook comes down. There's loads of guys from throughout the trade, and it's just a great 24 hours of just guys meeting up and playing cricket. But after that, it was then into the autumn campaign of fishing on my Lincolnshire Syndicate, and we all know what autumn's like. It's a great time of the year to be on the bank. Fish are always looking nice, nice colours. They've got the spawning out of the way. They've started to feed up again. They're weighing a little bit bigger. And to give you an idea, one of the fish that I caught in the summer months at 38 pounds, one of the guys ended up catching it in early autumn at about 43 pounds. So that has already put 5 pounds of weight on. So, you know, this is what some carp can do at that time of the year. But really enjoy fishing in the autumn. And I kick things off with, well, what I consider to be a really nice catch from the Syndicate, in that one morning I ended up catching three fish over 35 pounds, all absolutely banging fish. It shows the different mix of strains that's in that lake. There's some really nice scaly mirrors, there's some sort of almost leany looking fish with those lovely white tips, and also a few simos as well. But that's not me end of season fishing on that lake. I did go back to the Lincolnshire Syndicate a few times this year, but the fishing started to get a little bit tricky. I caught a few more nice carp to over 30 pounds, but my fishing was a little bit hit and miss on there, because I'm back into the time of the year when I get to do a lot of commitments for Avid, lots of filming elsewhere. And I went to a lot of other different waters as well, including one of the most spookiest carp lakes in England, apparently. It's called the Hook Lake. It's in Hertfordshire. It's run by my old mate Richard Stangroom, and that lake's been carp fished by a lot of really famous carp anglers for many years. It's been run as an exclusive syndicate for many years, and I've known Richard for over 30 years now, and he's been telling me about that lake and about how spooky it is down there. And it is a spooky old lake, and I went down there and fished for, I think it was 3 or 4 nights. Ended up catching a lovely carp right at the death. Tricky fishing, because it was, you know, pretty patchy with the weather, but I had a really nice time down there. And another venue I also went to, and this was on behalf of Avid, we went down to Ashmead. You might have seen on the Avid channel already that last year I went to Ashmead and we did a film on there. But this year we went down there in the autumn. The last trip that we'd done was in the spring, and we was down there for just over a week. And as is always the case at Ashmead, it's tricky fishing. It's not the easiest of lake. It's a real, can we call it, a maze of little back channels and pieces of water. It's a fantastic and really exciting lake to fish, and ended up catching some nice fish. The last trip I'd done down there, I think the biggest that I caught was about 29 pounds. So I went there with the intentions of hoping to get a 30 pounder, and I caught some really nice fish, including a really, really special one. But you'll have to find out how I got on in a film that's on the Avid channel, so keep your eye out for that one. But after that, we was back to the tricky time of autumn, which is always a tricky time of the year to fish. I did a few tutorials as well on Girton. I always tend to do a few tutorials in the spring and in the autumn time, and they're on Cove Lake. Anybody that's interested in them, you know, just get in touch with me via social media. And in between doing those, I was also doing the odd day on Girton Main Lake, and had a real good session on one night. I caught 4 30-pounders to mid 30s in a night, which is a pretty decent result. I think I caught about 8 fish in a day as well. The fish were really on me, the wind was blowing on me, and that was topped by a really nice mid 30 mirror and another mid 30 common as well. And I've got a little bit of footage of that now to show you.
Well, there's a lovely example of a carp caught on the elevate rods, caught on the 12 foot, 3 3/4 pound. That's a 33 pound common up in Nottinghamshire. Absolutely lovely.
Still got another night left on here. Sam's about to pack up with the cameras in a minute because he's got to head off home, but I've still got plenty of fishing left for the year. I've got a trip to the south of France in a couple of weeks' time. I'm there for 2 weeks, and then I'm joining a new syndicate over the winter months in Nottingham, which has got a lovely 50 pound common in it. So fingers crossed, I'll have something else to tell you about next time we catch up. But I hope you've enjoyed listening to me ramble on about what's been going on this year, and I hope also you've liked the look of this lake. It's a fantastic venue, this one. It's called Esnes Quarry. It's on the outskirts of Wolverhampton. You'd not believe we're in a sort of black country area at the moment. It's nice and quiet, lots of countryside around us, and this venue's got loads of nice carp in it as well. So if you're interested in fishing in here, then get yourself onto the Go Catch app and you'll find all the details and get yourself booked on. But thanks to Ed Matthews for having us down here. And I hope you guys have enjoyed watching. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the Avid channel for future films. And I'll catch up with you again real soon.